Well, welcome back to halftime on lmsc.com.au. 59-48 is the score at halftime. It was a thrilling finish. We've got Damien Martin, a Wildcat, and also an Eagle, an injured Eagle at the moment, Marto. Tell us what's wrong.
Yeah, I tore my quads about 4 weeks ago just doing some squats in the gym, and then retooled them last weekend with a double header. So unfortunately I've got to sit on the bench this game, but hopefully not for too long.
So tore the quads lifting the weights. What was the weight, mate? Was it a big weight or just a little one?
Oh, I wish I had a better story, but unfortunately I wasn't that happy. So yeah, a bit of a weakling in the squats, so yeah, a bit embarrassing.
What do you make of that finish to the first half? It was a bit of a thrill. It got out to 20 points. It didn't look so good for the Eagles, but Stevie Way, and I also thought Aaron Wigg was pretty good in turning things around.
Yeah, I mean, to their credit, they shot the hell out of it in that first quarter. The three-point percentage was just through the roof, so they were great the first quarter, but we kept our heads, and as you mentioned, Wiggy and Stevie in particular, I thought they were great offensively, but it was where the defense was letting us down, and we started switching and trying to take them out of their sets, and I think it worked to an extent.
That's one of the things we saw in the first quarter. He had 9 turnovers in the first quarter, and he actually had another 2 going into probably the first 2 minutes of the second quarter, so he had 11 early on. You know, is Chucky in there talking about handling the ball and talking about taking care of it?
Yeah, we let their defense take us out of it a little bit. I mean, they're playing full court, a bit of pressure, and I think we weren't expecting it, and we didn't handle it well at all. So once we started to relax and settle into the game, we started to run our offenses, but their four-court defense definitely took us out of our sets to begin the game.
That's right. And let's talk about the real story, the dunks. The dunks. How good have the dunks been in this game?
This is unbelievable. I had the full season with the Wildcats, but I think there's been more good dunks in this game than the whole season in the NBL. So
we have some absolute rippers in there from Morris and Colin, and then you know, Tommy Jervis finishing off the half.
Yeah,
absolutely. It's fantastic.
That is SPL basketball at its best. Let's talk about you personally. You're injured, but the Boomers are coming to town very soon. You've got a camp also next week. That's here in Perth?
Yeah, well, in 2 weeks from today, I'm actually supposed to fly to Canberra for a three-day, just a mini camp. And then after that, they're going to bring the boys back here for a 4 or 5 day camp and then some games against Argentina. So touch wood, I'll be all healthy by then. And I'd love to be able to play for Australia in front of the Perth fans. So.
Do you know what sort of a squad they're going to choose? You know, how many numbers and what sort of players? I mean, do you think you're a real chance, obviously after your season, you have to think that you're a strong chance to get in the final sort of 15 or 16?
I think with CJ and Paddy Mills out of contention at this camp, I think it definitely improves my chances. I think they're going to take about 16 into the Perth camp, and they'll probably travel around for the Argentina series with that squad. But then the main camp is in July, and that's when all the overseas players will return. And if I can make it to there, that'd be fantastic. If I can make the final team, then that'd be a blessing. But yeah, I'm just excited to be part of it.
Who are you up against? I mean, Adam Gibson, obviously. Della Dover, the youngster, who's a pretty active little kid.
Pretty good year this year for St. Mary's, absolutely.
Are they the ones you sort of got to compete against?
Yeah, Brett Brown's been pretty honest, and I think you'd be kidding yourself if Paddy Mills and CJ Brinton weren't your first two picks for the point guard position. CJ plays a bit of two as well, so it definitely opens up a spot for probably myself, Stevie Markovic, who plays in overseas. Matty Dellavedova, as you mentioned, had another great season for St. Mary's. So there's probably 4 of us vying for 2 spots behind Paddy Mills.
The 3-point shooting this year for you for the Wildcats, I mean, I reckon you could play the 2 now, can't you?
I mean,
you were landing those long, but what happened over that season?
I have no idea. Bit of extra work, and I got a few to drop, but they're extending the 3-point line now, so it took me 25 years to make a couple now, so I'm not sure how long it's going to take me to make it with the new line.
Absolutely. Well, talk to us about the Wildcats coming up this year. Now, we're real excited. We're off the back of a championship. Talk to us about who, you know, some of the key additions coming into the roster the coming this year.
I think Matty Knight is a massive pickup for us. He was the runner-up MVP 2 seasons ago when he was with the Sydney Spirit.
And played with you, didn't he?
Yeah, I had 4 years with him in college and then obviously 2 years in Sydney. So for me in particular, I'm really excited that he'll be back. And I think he's going to fit the style of game that the Wildcats play perfectly. And so I think he's our biggest pickup. But in saying that, just the fact that we've had so many returners, everyone's going to improve this year. We're all pretty young, so we know each other's game inside out. And yeah, there's going to be no awkward period of getting to know each other. Hopefully we can jump out of the gates from go.
You tell us what sort of a player Matty Knight is. I mean, you roomed with him at college. You played with him for many years. How different will he be to, say, Luke Shencher? I know he's smaller, but how different a player will he be, and how different will the game plan be with him in the side?
He's only about 6'8", but he's probably 125, 130 kilos. He's just as wide as they come, and he can move, he's agile, so he'll be able to get up and down the court, but at the same time, he's more of a banger than Luke Šenča, so he'll get in there and be physical. So he's strong like Galen Young, but he's probably got a few more offensive moves.
He's a great rebounder, isn't he? Really, when he was with West Sydney, he was really one of the league's best rebounders.
Absolutely. He's a double-double every night, he'll be fantastic for us this year.
Now, aside from Damian Martin, who would be one of my favourite players, just love him and Robbo, just a great combination. Stevie Way is also a great player. Here is the dunk from the first half. Absolutely sensational. Dave's going to set it up now. He's run round the back. We'll just put him on the spot. Here it is now. Stevie, just take us through this, Dave. Have you done this in your life?
Maybe on an 8'6" ring, but I think Stevie will bring that up after the game. He's one of the better athletes for the Wildcats and obviously for the Eagles. So it's good to see him getting out there and playing with a lot of confidence after having some time off on holidays.
So what's your talk to us through the second half? What's going to happen?
I think we'll be switching a lot and we'll be trying to make them play some one-on-one. I think their ball movement was very impressive in that first quarter when they got going. So we'll try and limit the impact of their screening. Switch a lot when we can and try and make them take us one-on-one so they get out of their team stuff.
Marto, thanks very much for joining us at halftime. Good luck with the Eagles. So you'll play in a couple of weeks' time?
Hopefully 2 weeks. I'll get a suit up.
Beautiful, mate. And good luck with the Boomers. Damian Martin joining us on lmsc.com.au. We're going to take a very short break. We'll be back with the second half. It is 11 points the margin. The Eagles, can they come back?